And welcome to the last part of our Walt Disney World May 22. We use the Disney Transport quite a lot. It's ideal being in a wheelchair because you do get to get on the bus first, but you have to wait for them to get the ramp out and to strap you in and everything. And I personally always feel like I'm really holding people up. I feel like sort of quite exposed and, you know, embarrassed that people are having to wait for me to get on and off the bus. But that being said, we nearly always get a seat on the bus, so it is ideal, and the Disney Transport is great, and they always strap you in really tightly, so it's an ideal way to travel around in a wheelchair. This was one of the last full days we spent in the Magic Kingdom, and we made really good use of Genie Plus on this day. One of the first things we did was go and check out the Enchanted Tiki Room.
If we weren't in the show, starting right away, we'd be out there. All together in the tiki 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 room, in the tiki 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 room. All the birds sing and the flowers grow in the tiki 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 room.
But we buck out, every cloud has a silver line.
Monsieur and Madame, it's time to say adieu, but we hope you will always remember the amazing things which happen here in Walt Disney's Enchanted Tiki Room.
After that, we headed over to the Country Bear Jamboree, which I thought was amazing. I definitely want to go and see this again. I just thought it was great fun. Loved it.
The Five Bear Runs. Hey, Uncle Bear, my bear's on play now in the good old key of G. Zink and Zamp, Tim, friend of our name Tennessee. Zink's twang.
You leave this love of mine. Bright lights and taverns, that's where you'll spend your time.
And through a gate, he's straight around the middle and he's broad across the front. Running 90 miles an hour, taking 30 feet a jump. Ain't never been caught and ain't never been treed. Some folks say he looks a lot like me.
We then used Genie Plus to get a really good view for the parade. You stand in front of the partner statue, and because we were sort of there quite early and I'm in a wheelchair, we got to stand right at the front. And if you use Genie Plus to watch the parade from here, you get such a good view of it. So if you've got Genie Plus already, it is well worth using it to get yourself a priority spot for the parade. This is the Festival of Fantasy Parade. It's the first time I've seen it. I thought it was brilliant. I had a lot of fun watching it. Just be aware that it can get really hot whilst just sitting there waiting for it and waiting for it to go past. It was a really hot day and we did get a bit sort of overwhelmed by the heat whilst we were watching it, but still so much fun, and I'm really glad we stopped to watch it, and it was a really good use of a Genie Plus thing.
Thank you.
ride, we used Genie Plus to go on some more rides, including Space Ranger Spin, which I kicked Neil's ass at. We also went on the Jungle Cruise.
I'm so going to be a loser. Yeah, actually, he looks pretty dead. Tired?
After that, we headed back through Tomorrowland. We caught a glimpse of Stitch. We went on one of my all-time favourites, the Carousel of Progress, and then on to Peter Pan's Flight.
Beautiful tomorrow. Just a dream away.
Neil managed to get a ride on Space Mountain before the heavens opened and absolutely chucked it down. It did stop raining after a while and we managed to get some food, and it did then stay dry and we were able to go and see Enchantment for the first time. Now there is a designated wheelchair viewing for the fireworks show, but it is first come, first serve. If you're not there at least an hour early, you're not going to get the greatest view. We were stood on the sort of second row of people while I was sat in a wheelchair, and as you can see, my view was very much hindered by this lighting rig. And actually, I don't think this particular viewing place was that great. Like, you couldn't really see the projections on the castle that well from where I was sat in the chair. And like I said, because we sort of hadn't arrived there that early, there were people in front of us, which did make it a little bit tricky to see. With that said though, the cast members are really, really good ensuring that all of the people in this area for wheelchair viewing or disabled viewing do get the best view. The cast members here are really good. So yeah, don't forget to check out the designated viewing areas if you are disabled or in a wheelchair. Whilst I really enjoyed it, I don't know, for me personally, I didn't like that they had re-recorded the songs, and I didn't like that the projections on the castle were just of the characters. Nothing really told a story, and I think that was a little bit of a shame. That said though, it was a lot of fun, it was really cool, it's very pretty, and it is really worth a watch. Next day, we headed over to Epcot again, because believe it or not, there was still some food we hadn't tried. Epcot is, I think, definitely one of my favourite parks. I really love Epcot, and we wanted to do a couple of the rides again, like Figment and the Grand Fiesta Tour.
Caballeros, tricky, caballeros, they say we are going to be there. We're coming, amigos, no matter where he goes.
We'd headed over to Epcot a bit later in the day because we wanted to do Harmonious in the evening, so we just spent some time having another look around all of the pavilions. I think Mexico is my favourite. It's just really cool in there. I love the Mexican pavilion. I love all of the orchids outside. They're really beautiful. We saw a classic Disney duck outside the America Pavilion, and then we made the mistake of going and watching The Great American Adventure, which I highly recommend you go and watch because it is quite the wild ride and I think really glosses over some of the worst parts of American history. It's very patriotic. I did see some people coming out of there with tears in their eyes. It's well worth a watch if you've never seen it. So just like Enchantment at Magic Kingdom, Harmonious also has a designated disability area or viewing place. There are a few dotted around. Again, it is first come, first serve. If you don't get there early, you don't get the best view. We happened to get there early and were right at the front, but my view was slightly hindered by the railing. You are that bit lower down in a wheelchair, and I did have to sort of lift myself up and out of the chair to be able to see it. But Harmonious was amazing. It was better than Enchantment. I absolutely loved Harmonious. I thought it was beautiful, really, really beautiful. If you can only see one show while you're there, definitely go and see Harmonious because it is just, it's out of this world. It's absolutely glorious. The water, the lights, the firework, the music, it is stunning. It's really out of this world. I loved Harmonious so much. Was in between Mexico and Canada, just behind port of entry, and I will say the view from here is smack bang in the middle of things. You can really see everything. You're super close, so close in fact that we did get covered in bits of firework and ash. It is a really stunning view from here, so there are some benefits to being in a wheelchair. I will say that being this close, it did get a little bit smoky, which made it a little bit hard to see at times. But overall, the view from here was absolutely phenomenal. Last full day, we headed over to the Polynesian for a little bit of a look. It was a really miserable, wet, damp and horrible day, but we did manage to get a walk up for Kona Cafe, where we had a very nice breakfast, which I will cover in another vlog. We then took the monorail over to the Magic Kingdom to pick up some last minute bits for people, and we did spot Donald Duck and Pluto in the Grand Floridian Station, which I thought was a lot of fun. It was very cute to see them there on the platform. So we're just in the hotel lobby. It was the last day yesterday. We're flying home today and we're checked out. I did that online through the My Disney Experience app. It was really easy. Saves having to go to the desk because actually a lot of people are checking out today. So the front desk is really busy. Our flight isn't for a couple of hours yet. We're going to head to the airport soon because we might as well sit there than sit here. Got my brand new Sesame Street hat on. But we had a really good holiday. The second week was a lot hotter than the first week, sort of almost unbearably so.
and I think we've talked about if we came again in May, we'd come a week earlier and have two sort of weeks early in May when it is a little bit less hot. And this second week has also been quite rainy. We've had a lot of thunderstorms this week, which has been a bit of a nightmare trying to dodge them. Like yesterday was kind of a write-off really, because of the rain and the thunderstorms, which wasn't ideal. So yeah, I think if we were going to come again, we would definitely come a week earlier and try and sort of avoid some of that. But all in all, it's been a really good 2 weeks. We've got loads done. We managed to do nearly all of the rides that we wanted to do. There was a couple at the Magic Kingdom that we didn't get to do, like the Journey of the Little Mermaid and the Winnie the Pooh ride, and we didn't get to do Splash Mountain. But yeah, we got lots done, and I'm really pleased with all the rides I went on. I went on some of the Big Girl rides, which I was a bit scared to, but I'm really proud of myself for going on them. I went on like Everest and Big Thunder Mountain and the Seven Dwarfs Mine Train, and sort of, for me, they're quite scary roller coasters, so I'm pretty proud of myself for going on them. But yeah, we've had a really good 2 weeks. We've eaten way too much food, we've spent way too much money, but all in all, it's been a really, really good holiday. And actually, we're back again in like a couple of months. We're back here again in November, like a Christmassy couple of weeks, which we're really excited about. We were gonna book some Mickey's Not So Scary tickets, but actually they were really expensive, and on the day we did decide to sort of just go for it and buy the ticket, when we tried to do it, neither of us could get it to work. It wasn't working. We couldn't pay for it on the app, so we just decided really it wasn't meant to be. So we're not going to do Not So Scary this year, which is a bit of a shame. It would have been exciting to see it, but it was really expensive. So what we're going to do instead, I think, is wait and see if they release any Very Merry Christmas tickets, and if they do have any dates in November, we think that'll be a little bit cheaper than sort of closer to Christmas, so hopefully we can do that instead, which will be really fun. So anyway, yeah, looking forward to coming back. It's been a really good couple of weeks, and we are heading home today. We'll be back in the UK tomorrow morning before 8. I can't remember exactly what time, but it's before 8 o'clock tomorrow morning. And then we're driving home from Heathrow back to Devon. So I'll let you know how that goes.
So we're now at MCO. We've come through check-in. Is that what it's called? Check-in. We checked in. That was really easy. We did self-check-in with the help of a man. Then we checked in our bags and we found the assistants, which was sorted out really quickly and really easily, so that was great. Then we got through security pretty quick, and now we're just gonna sit here and wait for our flight, and my head has a dent in it from where I've been wearing my hand. But yeah, we're just in the airport now. I've got some Cheetos, Neil's got a Twinkie, and we're just gonna wait for our flight now. But we're going home. It's very sad.
That's it for my Florida series. That was part 4. Thank you so much for watching. I'll be back soon with a couple of other videos, but for now, don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you soon.